Hello students, welcome to today's lecture on data structures. So in our previous session we have discussed about the introduction to linked list, and also we have gone through the list of operations that can be performed on linked list, and we explored the first operation on linked list, that is insertion operation, with three cases: insertion at the beginning, insertion at the end, and insertion at some intermediate position into the singly linked list. Okay, today we'll continue the topic of singly linked list, and we will see the other operations that can be performed on singly linked list. If you can recollect the other operations that can be performed on SLL from our previous session, one is deletion operation, and the other operations are traversal and display, count the number of nodes. And there are other possibilities, reversing singly linked list. And we will go through these operations today. We'll focus on the deletion operation first. You see this deletion operation also uses three cases. That means you can delete a node from singly linked list in three ways. The first one is deleting the first node from singly linked list, and deleting the last node from singly linked list. Similarly, deleting any intermediate node from singly linked list. Now we'll focus on each operation now. So how to delete the first node? Let's have a look at this diagram. Assume that this is the singly linked list, and I want to delete this first element. Suppose if list is not containing any node, that means if start is equals to null, it means list is empty, then you cannot delete anything from the linked list. So that is our first case. If singly linked list is empty, then there is nothing to delete. So simply display the message list is empty with the help of printf. Okay, printf list is empty. We do that. If list is not empty, that means there are some nodes. For example, in this example, we have three nodes. And I want to delete the first node from the list. I want to delete the first node from the list. Initially, start will be here. Start will be here. So what I will do is, I will take a temporary variable temp which points to the start node. So that is our first step. Temp is equal to start. So what happens? Temp points to the node where start is pointing. So initially, start is here. So temp points to this node. Okay. And then we move start node from here to here. Therefore, now start pointer is pointing to the second node. So that is our second step. How do you move? Start is equal to start next. So by using this statement, start variable will be moved to the second node. And now from this node onwards, the remaining linked list will be there. And we have to remove this. We have to remove this node. Can we remove it physically? Yes, because the node is created dynamically with the help of malloc. You can always remove that memory which is created dynamically with the help of free. So what we do is, we perform free of temp. Okay, the name of this node is temp. So we perform free of temp, so to release this memory. Okay, therefore after deleting this node, the list is from here only. Okay. From the start variable until the null pointer, the linked list will be assumed. So that is what our algorithm says. The first step is, if list is not empty, first step is take a temporary variable and let it point to the start node. And then move the start node to the next node. So start is equal to start next. And then free the temporary variable which is pointing to the first node. So this is how we can delete the first node from a singly linked list. And this is its diagram. Okay. Similarly, we can delete the last node from the singly linked list. If there is no element in the singly linked list, the first case is going to be same for all the deletion operations. If there is no element in singly linked list, then what we do is display list is empty. Okay. List is empty. Otherwise, what we do is, if list is not empty, that means there are some elements, Then what we do is, because we want to delete this last node, we take two temporary pointers, T and P, which will be pointed to the starting node at the beginning, the start node. We begin T and P here. Okay. And while T next not equals to null, we move T and we keep P to follow P, T. Okay. That means, so P will be kept here in place of T and T will be moved here. And in the second iteration, T will be moved here, P will be kept here. And in the third iteration, T will be moved here, P will be kept here. So at the end, when T points to null, T next points to null, T will be the last node and P will be its previous node. Okay, and we are going to remove this node. Okay, we are going to remove this node pointed by T. Therefore, this will become the last node. So how do you represent that this is last node? This next, P next is equals to null. Okay, so we make this P next that points to null. And then we remove this with the help of free, free of T. Okay, so these are the steps. Okay, the steps are use two temporary pointers P and T which are initially pointing to the start. So that is our first thing. So T is equals to P is equal to start. So while T next not equal to null, that means until T reaches the last node, what we are doing, P is equal to T, that means P takes the position of T and T moves to the next position. T is equal to T next. This step will be performed until T moves to the last node and P follows it. Okay. So when this loop is completed, the situation will be like this. T will be pointing to the last node and P will be pointing to the last before node. Then what we need to do, we assign null to the P next. That is, P next is equal to null. And finally, the node which we want to delete is T, we will free it. Okay, so free of T. So this is how you can remove the last node from a single linked list. Okay. And another thing that you need to perform here is, even though it is not written here, what you need to do is you need to handle one element condition also, single element condition also you need to perform. How do you know that there is only one element? If start next is equal to null, it means there is only one element. Then what you need to do is, you simply assign start is equal to null and remove that node. Okay, so I'll show you how to do it. Right. Let us see the other case. If start next is equal to null, it means there is only one element. Okay, then what we will do is we take a temporary variable, let us say T is equals to start, and then because there is only one node and if we delete it, start must point to null only. Start is equal to null. This makes the list empty. Okay. And then remove that memory pointed by T, free of T. So this is our first case. If this is not true, that is, if there are more than one elements, then this is going to be else part. Else we perform this step. Right? So this is what the complete algorithm is. This case must be properly handled. What is that case? If list is not empty, then handle this single element case. You need to handle that single element case properly. I forgot to write that. you need to handle this single element case in the next operation also. How do you handle it? If start next is equal to null, which means there is only one element, then take a temporary variable t that points to start and make that start points to null. Because if there is only one node, if you remove it, it's going to be empty linked list. So start is equal to null means that linked list is empty, and then remove that first node, free of. Okay. So this is how single element case is handled. Here you don't need to handle it separately, because anyhow you are moving start is equal to start next. So start will definitely point to null. That is why I have not written the single element deletion condition here. So there is no need to write a single element case for deletion of first node. But for deletion of last node, you must handle it separately. That is why I added it here. Okay. So this is how it is done. And the third operation is deletion of intermediate node. That means we want to delete some other node other than first node and last node. Again, the first case is going to be same. If singly linked list is empty, then display the message list is empty. If it contains one element, if there is only one element, then you cannot delete it, because intermediate nodes we are looking for. So we'll take which element you want to delete. That is, for example, second element or third element or fourth element and so on. So we'll take the position of the element, and that position must be greater than one to delete. And position must be less than number of elements in the linked list. It must be in between the first element and last element. So we are making sure that the node which we are deleting is in between the first node and last node. Okay. Then what we do? The process is going to be like this. Okay. There are some elements now. So if you observe, we are not handling a single element condition here. So what we need to do is, we take two temporary pointers again, previous and temp. And suppose I want to delete the third node. I want to delete the third node. Okay. So the position is POS is 3. So what I do is, initially TMP and previous will be pointing to start node, the first node. And the control is counter is equal to 1. If counter is less than the position, we will move previous and temp forward. Okay. So while counter is less than position, the position we are assuming is 3. So 1 less than 3, it is true. So previous is equal to T, and TMP is equal to TMP next, counter plus plus. So what we are doing, previous comes over here. Initially, previous and temp will be here. So previous will be here itself. Temp moves over here at the beginning. Again, it checks the position. Position is 2. Therefore, again, it is repeated. Previous comes to the temp position and temp moves forward. Now the counter is 3. Okay. So when the counter is 3, that means TMP reached the position of the node which we want to delete. So we want to delete this node. How do we delete? These two links are used to maintain this in the linked list. So what we do is, we connect this link of previous. See this carefully. Link of previous is actually connected to TMP. Now I remove that connection, and I will connect that previous next to the TMP next. This node is TMP next. So previous next is connected to TMP next. That's what I do. So after completing the loop, TMP will be pointing to the node which we want to delete, and previous will be pointing to the previous node. Okay. So previous next is equal to TMP next. Previous next is equal to TMP next. What is TMP next? That is the node D. Okay. So this link is established. Now you can remove this. The node pointed by TMP can be removed. How? Free of TMP. Okay. So what we are doing is simple. You iterate a loop until you reach the position of the node which we want to delete. And during that process, move a temporary pointer forward and use another pointer to follow that temporary pointer. This is actually previous is equal to TMP, actually small mistake. It is TMP. Previous is equal to TMP. Okay, and then TMP is equal to TMP next counter plus plus. Once you reach that node which we want to delete by TMP, then connect the next of previous to TMP next and remove this node with the help of free. That is how you can remove any intermediate node. Okay, and you need to observe that you are not handling the single element condition, because if there is only one element, it is going to be the first node and the last node. So we don't delete it. Okay. And traversal and displaying the node data in singly linked list is a easy operation. We'll start a temporary variable t at start. If start is equal to null, we display the message list is empty. Otherwise, there are some nodes, so we need to display the data of each node. What I do is, while t not equal to null, t is initially at start variable, start pointer, then I will display the data pointed by t. Okay. So how do you display the data pointed by t? By using printf percentile d t data. Okay, so t is initially at start variable. While t not equal to null, display the data in t and move t forward. Display the data in t and move t forward so that t now points to the second node. Again, it checks whether there is a node and displays the data, moves to the next node. And this loop will be repeated until t reaches null. When t reaches null, it means there are no nodes in the single linked list. Okay. So we begin temp here. Okay. Display 10, move forward. Display 20, move forward. Display 30, move forward. Display 40, move forward. Then it reaches null. When it reaches null, stops the process. Okay. So similarly, counting the nodes is also same. Instead of displaying, we perform count plus plus. In place of that printf statement, if you observe, in place of that printf statement, we simply do count plus plus. By initializing count is equal to zero, we perform count plus plus and the same loop while t not equal to null and perform this t is equal to t next. At the end of this loop, you will get the total number of nodes in the linked list. So return count. Initially, if start is equal to null, it means there are no nodes in the singly linked list. So we will return zero. Okay. So this is for counting the number of nodes in linked list. Now, this is the most difficult operation and also the most important operation for your examination point of view also. Reversing a singly linked list. Okay. It is difficult to understand. But if you focus, I think you can understand. What we need to do is, suppose the linked list is like this. First node is 1, second node is 2, third node is 3, fourth node is 4, and then fourth node is pointing to null. Then after reversing the singly linked list, it should be like this. 4 points to 3, 3 points to 2, 2 points to 1, and 1 points to null, reversed. For doing so, what we do is, we take three temporary pointers, previous, current, and next, which are initialized to null. Previous is initialized to null, CURR is initialized to head, the starting pointer, and NXT is initialized to null point. Okay, and then we make use of a loop by performing a check on current pointer. While current not equals to null, that means while current does not reach the end of the list, what we do is NXT is equal to current next. That means the next node will be assigned with a temporary pointer NXT. Current next is equal to previous, and current next is initialized as previous. Previous is equal to current, and current is equal to next. So it is difficult to understand this by looking at this code. I think it will be easy for you to understand if you look at this. See what is happening here. It is showing all the steps one by one. Watch it carefully so that you will understand it. How the links are changing. Now, if you look at this, previous and next are initialized to null, current is initialized to head, and the changes are done according to the algorithm. They are performed like that. So my suggestion is you take a piece of paper and practice this on that paper by performing the steps in the given order so that you will remember how the operation is performed. Okay, so you can go through this algorithm several times. You can go through this slide several times until you understand how it is happening. Try to do these four steps until the current reaches null. Okay, so that is my request. All of you, please watch this several times and perform it in your own by taking any linked list of your own. Perform those four steps which are listed inside the while loop, then you will understand after practice only. Otherwise you will not understand this. Okay, so watch this until you understand and practice it on paper. And I am again telling you, this operation, the reverse operation of single linked list, is very important in examination point of view. Somehow you should learn this topic. Okay, and these are the basic operations on singly linked list that we covered so far. And to check whether you understood anything from these operations, try to perform these operations on singly linked list. So I'm giving you four example operations. First one is L1 and L2 are two singly linked lists. And to append L2 to L1, you need to write the code. It's very simple. What you need to do is, you write the code to reach the end of L1. Okay, write the code to reach the end of L1 with the help of a loop. How do you write? For example, t is equal to L1, while t next not equal to null, t is equal to t next. That's it. So you will reach the end of L1 pointed by t. Then attach the first node of L2 to that node t. So how do you do that? T next is equal to L2. That simple it is. Okay. So I leave this merging appending operation to you. All of you write down that as an assignment. And also another operation that you need to practice is how to display the contents of a singly linked list in reverse order. Display the contents of singly linked list in reverse order. Okay, starting from the end, you need to reverse. You need to display it. Not reversing, display the contents in reverse order. Singly linked list must be same. It should not be changed. But I want the contents of the list to be displayed in reverse order. I'll give you a clue also. Use recursion for displaying the contents of a single linked list in reverse order. Okay, you can go through some online content to see how it can be displayed in reverse order. Then write a code for searching an element in single linked list. It's very easy because you wrote the code for counting number of elements. In place of that count plus plus, you perform this comparison operation. That means if ELE is equal to T element, T cap element, it means it's going to be a successful search. Otherwise, T is equal to T next. And also sort the elements in singly linked list. Use any basic sorting technique on singly linked list. Okay. So that's all for today. This is about a singly linked list operations. And when we come back, we start doubly linked list concept, and also we see how to perform these operations on doubly linked list.